Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests.
Good evening.
The easiest role in a table in a Toastmaster session is being a tabletopic speaker. I was thinking that is true till the moment I came here. Not today, the first time when I attended a Toastmasters meeting. But after a certain period of time, I learned how to attend a tabletopic session. What I was told is, forget about the audience. Go there and blast like anything. Whatever you know, you speak. That was the attitude I had. And after some time, I learned how to attend a tabletopic session, and there are certain procedures how to attend a tabletopic session. You need not do a Wikipedia or encyclopedia and look into what is to be done. But certain points, if you follow, it is very easy to attend. What they say is a prep approach, or you call it as an AIDA, A-I-D-A, SMG-PPF. Prep is nothing but you take a point, position yourself, tell a reason, then an example, and come to the point again. You finish off. That completes your 2 minutes. The next one is AIDA. What they say is, you grab the attention of the audience, create an interest, then instill a desire and call for action. Okay, those are a little bit difficult, but nothing to worry about that one. The other approach is, tell a story, give a message, and then give a goal to the audience, or gain, what is the gain the audience get from the speech you gave. And finally, you can relate to past, present and future. Say about the past, tell about the present, and lead to the future. And let's see how our tabletopic speakers perform today. First thing is Toastmaster Haseem. Yeah, you did a perfect tabletopic speech, I believe. So when you came over here, you just started saying that your question was, when did you not speak up when you know you should have? You told that I speak every time. So you positioned that you haven't faced a time that you did not speak up. So then you started narrating about how you, an incident about the discussions which you had with your wife. And then finally you positioned yourself saying that I haven't faced a point at all in my life where it happened that I could not speak up. What I felt is an example, a clear example, in the example and reason it was a mixed up thing which I was feeling about it. Otherwise it was a good attempt, a good position, reason, example and position. And again, Toastmaster Raj Mohan, the second speaker. If you have to teach someone, what would it be? You told that prefer to learn to love yourself. That was your point. Okay, excellent. Then you went into the reason. If you don't love you, you will not have improvement. You will not be motivational. And you kept on saying on reasons and reasons and reasons. I was waiting for an example. It was a bit missing there. And finally, you told that, so I tell others to love themselves. It was a good attempt, but if you can add an example to that one, come out very well actually. Good approach, good luck. Let us give a round of applause. Toastmaster Ajay Sharma, what would you do differently if you knew no one was judging you? I loved it actually. Today evening also I was just dancing and my wife came to me, what's going on wrong with you? He took a point saying that yes, I like dancing, when nobody is judging me, I will dance. And then he talked about he loved dancing, relaxes, what are the reasons for dancing is your priority whenever you are alone. That was all excellent. Again, I felt you could have stated a particular example where you really enjoyed dancing. That could have added more weightage to the speech. And finally, you told that if you judge yourself, if you are not good in yourself, then you need somebody to judge. It's a good stand, a good tabletopic attempt. And coming to Mr. Taqir, I think you are a professional speaker, correct? I think you told in your introduction also. Your approach, I felt that take it in past, present, future, or a story, message, and gain for the audience. What is it? Past, you told excellently well how. In first thing is you got before that. First thing is you got the attention of the audience, saying that I don't wear a tie. So it was about attire, correct? What do you think is the function of an attire? Then you talked about, you told a story about Egyptian culture, how it came up. That's the past. So how in the recent 20 years, the present, you are wearing tie. And finally you said that if the progress of human race is going on and we will be changing for whatever is good for the future. So that's a different approach he had taken up. That maybe it comes for a seasoned speaker, but for beginners also you can approach it in certain ways to excel in the future. So that's a very good one. Toastmaster Arshan, when you think of your home, what immediately comes to your mind? You are asking for the topic, that's fine. you couldn't understand the topic, so you asked it. And then you were talking about, yeah, I want certain changes to bring in my home and the family and other things. That's all. You had taken the stand that you want some changes in the family or in the home. Then you need to build on to that one. Just state a reason why you want changes to that one. You can think, see, you need not worry about anything. Come over there, it's time for you to speak. That's all. Forget everything and keep on speaking. Okay, in the beginning, I was looking for words actually when I used to come to table topic speeches first time. But over a period of time, Kalivali, who's sitting there, is all friends. If you don't speak well, no issues. Enjoy your speech. Whenever you're on the stage, enjoy. That's the key to success. And if you just try on these approaches, on something, position, that's the best one I would say. Because it's a question. What is that you want to exchange? What is that you want, you think immediately when it comes to your mind? Say something, position, reason, give an example, then come back to the point. You'll finish up very well. I think all the speakers attempted very well. A good table topic session conducted by a very good table topic master.